Over the last decade, my area of research has really focused on bringing together interdisciplinary teams of people to try and address some of those larger challenges that are facing society, in particular the use of the oceans. The world has been to recognise that the oceans may solve some of the issues that are facing us. In particular, you know, the oceans cover almost 3/4 of the Earth's surface, 71%. And of that, only a very narrow area, the coastal margins, which are less than 8%, are those areas which have really been utilised and, in fact, often overutilised. So what we're interested in is looking at, if you're going offshore and using those other areas of the research, what are the opportunities there for, in particular, for food and energy production systems? And in many ways, it's almost like a greenfield site. And so going out there, we need to make sure that we look after the environment, that we're socially acceptable, and also it's got to be financially viable for industries to go out there. So I think it offers a new opportunity for us. And Australia, with the third largest exclusive economic zone, that's the jurisdiction of waters that Australia owns, we can be a global leader in being able to facilitate that move offshore and ensure that it meets those strong environmental credentials that we think society would want us to do. We actually think that maybe the shift offshore can actually help address some of those issues. Other areas that I've been working on is to really think about what Tasmania in particular, but Australia does well from an export seafood potential. We're really strongly based on reef-based species, things like rock lobsters and abalone. Largest export is rock lobster from Australia, and for Tasmania it's abalone and rock lobster. And they're reef-based species. Now obviously that reefs, which are often the rainforests and the sea, are in our coastal zone. So if we want to go offshore, those reef systems are no longer available. So there's the opportunity to think about how we might address that from an ecosystem perspective, and that's to transfer that ecosystem offshore. So we've been thinking about the concept of using artificial reefs and floating those artificial reefs offshore. So that means that we suddenly create the rainforest of the sea further offshore. But we do that in an ecosystem way where we provide the habitat. So it's just not about monoculture of species offshore, but we actually start thinking about some of the ecosystem services that are provided by environmental systems, such as reef systems. And so we look at taking them offshore and the opportunity to use them as the structure in which to grow lobsters and abalone and kelp and a range of different species that we already harvest from our reef systems. We're fairly fortunate in Australia, and particularly in Tasmania, in that we have a really strong international reputation for the way we manage our marine resources into the future. And when we think about going offshore, we've actually got quite a good engineering offshore knowledge because of the oil and gas industry. And by using some of that knowledge and bringing it together with our biologists, bringing it together with the people from the Australian Maritime College who are working in marine renewable energy and offshore engineering, we've really got the right bits of the jigsaw puzzle to be able to tackle this. And I believe that we're incredibly well positioned to be able to be global leaders in that.